This 38 by 55 inch canvas depicts a group of 8 pioneers on the frontier. They fill the center of the painting and are arranged in a circle with a few sitting and the rest standing. To the left, there is a seated scout wearing a green wool coat and buckskin leggings. Leaning in with his right elbow propped on his thigh and a rifle tucked in close to his body, he raises his left arm in a gesture as if to draw the attention of the rest of the group. Everyone in the group is facing in his direction, except for a young woman who stands at the 12 o'clock position, facing the viewer and holding an infant upright in her arms. Both the woman and the baby wear shawls that drape over their shoulders and cover their heads. The group is surrounded by sagebrush and prairie grasses. Just behind the pioneers, on the right, is a white horse and a gleaming ivory-colored covered wagon. Surrounding the pioneers are their possessions: a few blankets, a cooking pot, a tea kettle, and 3 dogs. To the far left, smoke rises from a campfire. Further behind them, in the distance, there's another wagon, 2 more people, and 5 more horses. Filling the upper half of the canvas is a dark evening sky, clouds tinged with the pink hues of the setting sun. According to Peter Hasrick, this domestic scene contains hidden messages, one involving the woman.
If you notice, all the men are sitting or standing firmly on the ground. She, cradling a baby in her arms, seems to float above them. The 2 white horses that are on either side of her are almost like angels. One of the concepts that America had was manifest destiny. And manifest destiny suggested that Anglo populations had a divine right to take over the full American West. She is the personification of what was known then as the Prairie Madonna. She is evidence of a spiritual kind of sanctioning of what the family is doing, moving to the promised land as a Christian parable.